Can you guess name the largest snake in the world? Here's a hint. It's the title of a very famous horror movie. Did you guess it? Right, it's the anaconda. Now imagine pairing it with the largest crocodile, Cassius, which weighs nearly 1 ton. You could easily write a script for a new horror film. However, these giants are mere babies compared to those that roamed the earth long ago. Take, for example, Kronosaurus and Titanoboa. These two predators once posed a threat to all life, both on land and in water. But what would happen if they still lived today? Could humanity survive? Or would it spell our doom? Now let's explore the ancient monsters that once terrorized every living thing in their path. You'll discover when and where these behemoths lived, and then we'll transport them to the present. Will these giants dominate our world? Or will humans rise to the challenge? Something tells me things are about to heat up, but before we activate the time machine, let's get to know our colossal characters better. We'll start with Titanoboa. This prehistoric serpent lived about 58 million years ago, and, according to scientists, was the largest predator on the planet for at least 10 million years. Titanoboa could reach a staggering length of 13 meters, or 43 feet, and weigh over a ton. Can you imagine encountering this giant? Here's an illustration to help you grasp the immense size of Titanoboa. Imagine laying two adult giraffes end-to-end on the ground. Even then, Titanoboa would be longer. To put it in another perspective, consider this comparison between two vertebrae. The smaller one on the left belongs to an anaconda, the largest snake living today, while the colossal one on the right is from Titanoboa. This comparison shows that Titanoboa was twice the size of the largest snake we know today. In terms of width, Titanoboa could reach an astounding 1 meter or 3 feet across. This incredible girth means it could easily swallow a young hippopotamus whole, though it's worth noting that hippos didn't exist in its time. Instead, Titanoboa's diet primarily consisted of large fish and possibly other sizable prehistoric reptiles. This ancient serpent thrived in the warm, swampy environments and slow-moving rivers of what is now modern-day Colombia. The habitat of Titanoboa was likely filled with dense vegetation and murky waters, providing ample hiding spots for this ambush predator. It would have silently lurked beneath the water's surface, waiting to strike unsuspecting prey with lightning speed. The sheer power and size of Titanoboa meant it had few, if any, natural enemies, allowing it to reign supreme in its ecosystem. Imagine encountering this enormous snake as it moved through the swamps, its massive body creating ripples that disturbed the otherwise still waters. The presence of such a gigantic predator would have been a dominating force in its environment, influencing the behavior and evolution of other species around it. In summary, the comparison between Titanoboa and today's anaconda highlights the staggering size difference, underscoring just how formidable this ancient reptile was. Its ability to consume large prey and its dominance in the swampy habitats of prehistoric South America paint a picture of a true apex predator, one whose legacy continues to fascinate and awe us today. Besides fish, Titanoboa could also hunt crocodiles. It was a cunning predator. This enormous snake would ambush its prey and constrict it with immense power. Then the serpent would swallow its catch whole and digest it over a long period. The unfortunate victim experienced a compression force equivalent to 1.5 times the weight of the Brooklyn Bridge. To put that into perspective, it's 28 kilograms per square centimeter or 400 pounds per square inch. While Kronosaurus was smaller in comparison, it was equally vicious. Its gaping mouth filled with numerous sharp teeth says it all. The size of Kronosaurus was comparable to an orca, commonly known as a killer whale. Specifically, Kronosaurus could extend to more than 10 meters, or 33 feet in length, and weigh up to 12 tons. In appearance, it resembled a modern crocodile, but was significantly larger. Their bite strength was also comparably fierce. Kronosaurus was an expert swimmer, probably attacking its prey from below. It possessed a sturdy rib cage supporting its flippers and a small tail. Imagine Kronosaurus gliding through the ocean, its powerful flippers propelling it silently. With a quick lethal motion, it would lunge upward, capturing unsuspecting prey with its mighty jaws. This combination of size, strength, and stealth made Kronosaurus a top predator in its marine environment. Titanoboa and Kronosaurus represent two of the most formidable predators ever to exist. Their impressive physical characteristics and hunting methods highlight the incredible diversity and adaptability of prehistoric creatures. Envisioning these ancient giants in today's world, their presence would undoubtedly alter our understanding of the natural order and the limits of survival. Kronosaurus would gnaw at its victim, giving it no chance for survival. Kronosaurus and Titanoboa couldn't have encountered each other. They lived in different periods and likely preferred different habitats. Kronosaurus could have lived in the relatively cold southern seas, whereas Titanoboa thrived in hot climates. Despite these differences, both predators instilled fear and terror in all living creatures around them. Now imagine if these two monsters hadn't gone extinct and still coexisted with us today. But would it truly be peaceful? That's a big question. If Titanoboa had survived to this day, it could likely be found in the equatorial tropics. For instance, Titanoboa would love the hot climate of Colombia or neighboring countries like Venezuela, Brazil, Ecuador, Peru, or Panama. People in these regions would need to protect their homes more carefully from Titanoboa's intrusion. However, it's unlikely that such a massive snake could sneak into a house unnoticed. Titanoboa would have no trouble knocking out a window or even breaking through a door. Similarly, if Kronosaurus still existed, its presence in the oceans would be a tremendous threat to marine activities. Fishing in coastal communities would constantly be in danger. The massive marine reptile, with its powerful jaws and predatory nature, would make the seas extremely perilous. This is a serious question. If Titanoboa and Kronosaurus had survived into the present day, their immense size and predatory prowess would dramatically alter our world. These ancient giants would challenge human safety and dominance, necessitating significant adaptations and precautions to coexist with them. Fortunately, such behavior remains rare. Humans are not typical prey for snakes, but to protect themselves from potential intruders, people would likely need to surround their homes with high-voltage fences and keep a large stun gun under their pillows, just in case. In bustling megacities, a huge snake like Titanoboa would have almost no chance of survival unless it happened to hide somewhere beneath a heating main, a comfort that a reptile might appreciate. But food in the form of rats would hardly suit such a large predator. Interestingly, Titanoboa would probably not be interested in humans as a food source. In horror films, anacondas often devour people, but in reality, they rarely attack humans. We can assume that Titanoboa, its distant ancestor, would also be indifferent to humans. However, for people, Titanoboa could be a highly sought-after trophy. Zoos around the world would dream of acquiring such a valuable specimen, and its skin would become a coveted prize. Those who managed to capture these enormous snakes would become national heroes. As for Titanoboa's diet, it would find plenty to eat in our world. Alligators, turtles, and river dolphins would suit the giant snake perfectly. Animals on land would also face significant threats. Giant armadillos, manatees, tapirs, cougars, jaguars, caimans, and Brazilian otters would be at risk. While adult animals might be too large, their cubs and young would be ideal prey. Titanoboa wouldn't mind eating fish either, as it is a more familiar diet. This would disrupt the food chain significantly. Some animals might migrate to safer areas, but the fauna of the Amazonian forest would suffer greatly. On the other hand, insects and fungi might start to flourish and evolve due to the changes in the ecosystem. Very soon, there'd be no trace of the once lush vegetation. Kronosaurus would hardly enjoy life in our conditions either. In ancient times, even turtles were the size of a kitchen table. One turtle could satisfy it for an entire day. But today, such a monster would need about a dozen modern turtles, and even then, it might not be enough. In addition to turtles, the ancient predator fed on plesiosaurs. But in our world, it would need to find an alternative. Most likely, Kronosaurus would switch to large marine mammals. It wouldn't be able to swallow a whale whole, but in parts, it could eventually consume an entire whale. Such an enormous creature would require an immense amount of food. Acting like a colossal meat grinder, it would devour everything in its path. Humans would face significant hardships due to the resulting shortage of fish in the oceans. Fishing would become extremely perilous with this underwater menace lurking about. ships would need to be constructed much more robustly. The extinction of whales would trigger a climatic disaster, as there would be nothing to absorb thousands of tons of carbon from the atmosphere. The underwater world would become a battleground for survival. With the monster's massive size and aggressive nature, it would dominate the seas. Tourism and maritime travel in its habitat would be abandoned entirely. These danger zones would be clearly marked on all maps, warning people to stay away. First of all, I'm talking about Titanoboa. There's speculation that it thrived in temperatures around 32 degrees Celsius or 90 degrees Fahrenheit. With the current rate of global warming, such average temperatures could become a reality. Fortunately, it would take millions of years for those conditions to return. Would you like to see ancient monsters with your own eyes? Let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and share it with your friends. And stay tuned, as I'm already working on another exciting episode for you.